Want to create a stunning whiskey bottle, labeling blender in just 5 minutes? What if I told you there's a dead simple trick that even beginners can nail to make 3D models look like pro? Stick with me because I'm going to show you how to use the shrink wrap modifier to slap a perfect whiskey label on your bottle fast and flawlessly. Welcome back. Today we're crafting a premium whiskey label in blender that's perfect for product mockups, maybe game assets, or just showing off. The shrink wrap modifier makes this super simple and easy to wrap labels around bottles. If you want a soda or a water label instead, no problem. The steps are the same. Let's dive in. Right, we're going to start off with a whiskey bottle, which I made earlier, but you can download these from various sites if you wish, or you can model it yourself with step-by-steps that I've covered in previous tutorials. For this tutorial, we're just going to actually add a texture label to our bottle. Let's begin. So we're going to create the label. Now, this is going to be nice and simple because what we're going to do is we're going to actually just add in a image plane with Blender. So let's just do that now. We've got our basic bottle that you may have made yourself or downloaded, but we want to actually add the labels to this bottle. Quite simply, we're just going to add in some image planes. So add in, and then go to image, and we're going to add a plane mesh. And this is going to be an image plane. As you can see, this takes you directly to a file path, so you can actually add in your label that you wish. So you can see that these are different backs of labels because I experimented with quite a few designs, and I finally decided to settle with this one for the front. Click on that, and as you can see, we've got a label there on the front. So I'm just going to G and X just to move it forward, just so we can see it. As you can see, it's not very bright. You can actually add light into that. G and Z, I'm just going to move it up. You can actually go into its texture itself. And what we can do is go into emission, select a strength, say 20 watts. And then what we can do is actually go into image texture again and open that texture again, which will mean that we can actually add light, or you might want to add grunge or anything you wish to your texture. In fact, that's a bit too bright, so I'm just going to turn it down to 2. So we've now got our texture for our bottle. Right, I'm just going to rotate this round, rotate on the Z by 90, and I'm just going to reposition it just about here, because the red line shows X and Y and the green line shows front to back. So if we hit the 1 key, then we are looking from the front. And then just move it up to about the right place. I'm just going to scale this up. So I'm just scaling my image to actually want to attach it to this bottle. Right, if we attach this to this bottle, we can actually use our shrink wrap modifier now. Add, and we can actually just select S until you can find shrink wrap. And then we want the actual thing we're going to actually attach it to. So if we just actually click on our bottle, as you can see, it actually fixes it as a plane on our bottle. And then scale it up, scale it on the X, like that. As you can see, it's actually cutting through our bottle, and that's because the plane hasn't got enough geometry. As you can see, our plane hasn't got enough geometry, so it's actually inside the bottle as a glass plane. The way we can actually do this is we go to target normal project, like that, and then we're going to edit mode. I'm going to offset this by 0.01, so it actually appears in front of our glass bottle, and we need to add some subdivisions to our label. Press the tab key, takes you into edit mode, and we're just going to add some subdivision. So subdivide, and I'm just going to subdivide this by 30. And as you can see, that makes a grid. Now, what the grid does means that the actual, this can now be wrapped around the bottle. And as you can see, voila, it actually appears on the front of our bottle. And if we want to make our label a little bit more shiny, you just go into the label and mess about with some of the actual settings of the label, like the shininess. Now we can make it a really shiny label, and as you can see, the light started reflecting off it. And if you take it down to 0, then it looks like an actual transfer that you sometimes get on the modern bottles. Same for the back. I'm just going to add in a image mesh plane again, and it takes us straight into there. And then same thing again, I'm just going to actually select one that I think is appropriate, which is that one. Looking at our image, it's in the wrong orientation, so I'm just going to rotate it along the Z by 90. And then looking from the back, just make sure it's the right way around, which it isn't. So rotate in the Z by 180. And now, as you can see, the label is in the right place again. Press Ctrl and 1, and we can actually make it look from the back. Same again, scale it up, G, move it into place. I'm going to add the actual texture in once again on the emissions. And you can actually increase the actual strength of the actual emission just so it becomes a little bit brighter. Maybe a bit too bright that, so I'm just going to take it down to 1. And then into edit mode, subdivide by 30 again. Subdivide this by 30 in there. And then all we need to do then is add in once again spanner or wrench, and then we'll search for the shrink wrap modifier, just like that. Make the target the bottle again, and as you can see, sometimes this happens and it just means that you've got to actually slightly adjust your label. So let's just scale it along the X like that until it looks about right. And of course, we want this to appear in front of our bottle and not distort like we are actually getting there. So I'm just going to put 0.01 like that, so it's just above the actual glass bottle. And there you have it. Quite easily, quite simply, we've created a label on the front, and as you can see, and on the back of our bottle. Then Alt A to actually make everything reappear, just like that. And press F12, and we've got our labeled bottle again. There you have it. Perfect product shot. You've just labeled a whiskey bottle with a shrink wrap modifier. So easy. If this is helpful, smash that like button, subscribe for more blender tricks, and drop a comment. What are you making? A whiskey bottle, a sci-fi potion, or a soda can? I want to see your work. Drop me a line. Thank you for watching. Keep blending, and I'll catch you in the next one. Have fun creating, and of course, subscribe to my channel.